So my name is Jason Poon. I'm a graduate student at UC Berkeley, and I study power electronics, and I do my research in power electronics, including controls, circuits, magnetic design. So I'm part of the power electronics group at UC Berkeley, and we work on really any type of application related to power electronics. So what we're looking for are impactful, meaningful ways that we can contribute to real-world applications of power electronics. So my current research involves designing predictive, self-healing, and secure power electronics. So I'm looking at networks of power electronics converters or individual converters themselves and trying to think of ways to make them more reliable, more dependable, more fault tolerant. And the way I've been approaching this problem for now has been looking at ways to modify the control system associated with the power electronics converter to make the entire system more intelligent, more capable. So using the existing hardware that we're given, we can improve the overall reliability and fault tolerance of that power electronics converter. Going forward, we're also looking at different ways of modifying the circuits themselves, designing the converters in a way that will make them more fault tolerant from the ground up. So really looking at the state space description or the true model of the converter and seeing how the faults manifest and how we can prevent them. Yeah, so most of my day is spent doing research. A lot of it is in the lab, in the office, and it's just juggling whatever tasks need to be done to push forward the projects that we're working on. I'm also the TA for the undergraduate power electronics class at UC Berkeley, and this has been a really rewarding experience. I do a lot of stuff related to, from designing the content course, to running office hours, running the lab section, answering questions, and thinking of new ways to teach power electronics to undergraduates to make it engaging for students from all different backgrounds. To me, I think success, I don't think there's a binary definition for success, but I think to me, in order to be successful, it just means that you can't take any shortcuts. And, for my work, what that means is when we ask a question, first of all, is it the right question to be asking in the first place? And then once we start our investigation, making sure that we really dig into every single possible nook and cranny to really turn over every single stone to make sure that what we looked at everything. And this involves looking at the limits of different types of converters or control architectures, doing the most things that we can with the computational hardware that we're given, with the circuits that we're given, and trying to make these systems as smart, as reliable, and as capable as possible. To me, I think that's what being successful really means, is making sure that when you answer a question, you know that you truly understand every single part of the system that you're looking at, and you can say with really 100% certainty that there was no better way that you could have done this task. Before we had Typhoon, we found that there was a big jump from going from a pure computer-based simulation software that you would do for a power electronics converter, and then actually implementing it in hardware, in an actual converter with high voltages. So what we found is we would have an idea for a specific topology or control architecture that we wanted to test. It would work perfectly in simulation, but then we would go to an actual physical implementation and something didn't work.
Right.
We didn't know, what was wrong with it. So when that something didn't work, we had to go back to the simulation. Maybe there was some parasitics that we missed. Maybe there was some control loop that we missed. And then after that, we would have to go back to our physical implementation. And this created a lot of latency in our design process. And it made us more conservative in the types of ideas we could test. Because we knew if we were too ambitious, there's always inevitably going to be bugs in your final design. But the time it took to go back to simulation and back to hardware was too great that we wanted to be more cautious with that. Typhoon has been really great at acting as an intermediate step between our simulation and the full experimental implementation. It doesn't replace either, but I think it acts as a really good complement between the two. So once we have our design and simulation, we can really quickly test and validate our ideas using Typhoon on an actual controller. And this helps iron out a lot of the problems that we were having with our microcontrollers and our FPGAs, where we could implement a lot of the control architectures we were looking at, a lot of the fault detection and identification algorithms we were working at. And once we could really iron out all those bugs using Typhoon, then we could go with confidence to the hardware stage and have more confidence that it would work on the first try. So with a question that broad, I don't think I'm qualified to answer. I think to me, power electronics will always be a very important part in a huge variety of technologies, whether you're looking at mobile phones, whether you're looking at renewable energy or electrified transportation. Power electronics will always be a very critical aspect of all of these industries. And that's why I think power electronics is and will be, in the future, it'll be even more important than it is today for enabling a lot of these fields that are critical to, to the world, to ensuring that we're using resources sustainably, to ensuring that we can stay connected with our mobile devices, and giving more functionality to the technology and devices that we use every day. Power electronics are really the key enabler for these types of technologies. So that's why I think it's really important that we have a vibrant power electronics community, particularly with young undergraduate students who are still deciding what field they want to get into. I think power electronics is a really exciting option because the opportunities are only increasing, becoming more exciting every day. Well, I think me as an engineer and lots of engineers are just very curious in general. When we use devices, it's not enough just to understand how to use it, but we want to understand why is it like that in the first place? How? These are the types of questions that I don't think, not even just engineers, but just humans in general, we're curious people. And I think a lot of times today, some of that curiosity is kind of lost in a sense. People are, just very busy and they're only focused on the bigger picture or the bigger impact, or they're focused on the bigger picture of things. But I think there's lots of exciting stuff when you really dive down and think about something and why is it like that? Why does it work like that? How is it like that? These are the questions that I think are not only valuable questions for engineers to ask, but just people in general. So I would definitely tell them to consider power electronics as a very exciting opportunity to make a big impact in the field, not only in the energy field, but across all different types of technology. I think power electronics just touches on so many different disciplines not only in the field of electrical engineering, where you have, you know, circuits and control theory, but it also touches, you know, magnetics, packaging, thermal design, and of course applications. So if you're in power electronics, you're never going to be bored, because there's just so many different areas that you can explore, and there's lots of opportunities for exciting applications that are going to be really important in the future. I think, to me, you know, my mission has always been just to find really interesting questions, really interesting problems that people haven't really found a solution to, and trying to figure out, is there a way that I can contribute here? And that's always been my mission since I started my career in engineering. I was looking for meaningful problems to address, and not forcing a solution onto them, but really working at the edge of technology to figure out, is there a way that we can improve the situation?
Right.
And I think in the field of power electronics, there's lots of opportunities to do that. And yeah. Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of people who helped me get here, from teachers to advisors to research supervisors to all my colleagues. And it's certainly not, you know, research is certainly not an individual effort. It's, you know, a collaborative effort. And even here at APEC, there's so many colleagues who, just talking with them, you can get new ideas and get support for some ideas that you're thinking about. And, you know, research doesn't happen in a bubble. It's definitely a community. And it's great, you know, to see here at APEC that there's such a vibrant community in power electronics. And I hope that in the future, it's going to be even more vibrant.